Please do subscribe to our Nehra Classes YouTube channel and also turn on the bell notifications to receive the updates of our videos directly in your device. Hello friends, I Vikas Nehra welcome you all to our Nehra Classes YouTube channel. In today's tutorial, we will learn how to compile the Linux kernel. But before proceeding further, let me tell you the meaning of compiling the Linux kernel. Compiling a Linux kernel usually means downloading the source code, possibly modifying the source code. Most non-programmers don't usually do this, and then configuring the kernel. What features, modules, drivers we want to include. The procedure to build or compile and install the latest Linux kernel from source code is as follows. We grab the latest kernel from kernel.org, then verify the kernel. After that, we untar the kernel tarball, copy the existing Linux kernel config file, compile and build Linux kernel. After that, we install Linux kernel and modules, and then we update the grub configuration. For today's tutorial, I'm using 20.04 machine, and on this machine we have kernel version 5.4. So without wasting time, let's get started. In order to compile the Linux kernel, we would require few packages which must be installed in our machine. So we will first install these packages with the help of apt install command. The packages are build essential, rsync, gcc, bc, bison, libssl-dev, libncurses5-dev, libelf-dev. These packages must be installed in your machine. I have already installed these packages in my machine. Now in the next step, we will increase the bootloader timeout. So for that, we will open the etc default grub file in vi editor, or you can use your favorite file editor for that. And here we will come down to this line where grub underscore timeout is mentioned. In this file, the timeout settings are 0 seconds. Here we will make it as 10, and we will comment this line, grub underscore timeout underscore style is equal to hidden. We will comment this line and we will save the changes. Now in the next step, we will update the grub. So for that, we will execute sudo update hyphen grub command. It will update the init ram fs. Now in the next step, we will download the kernel source code. So we will open the internet browser, and there we will mention kernel.org in the address bar and press enter. And from here we can see the details of the different kernel versions. Let us suppose if I want to compile this kernel 5.9, and this is the tarball link. I will copy this link and I will use wget command to download this. Wget and the URL. Press enter. So it will download the tar file in my machine, and it will take few minutes. So I'm going to pause this video for a while and I will show you once it is downloaded. Zip file has been successfully downloaded. We can list this kernel tar zip file by executing the ls command after going there in the download location, and here it is. I have downloaded it in my home directory, and the name of this zip file is linux-5.9.tar.xz. Now in the next step, I will create a directory here with the name as Linux kernel, and in the next step I will untar this file. So here I will execute tar xvf linux. I will mention the name, or I can use asterisk here, hyphen c, and then name of the directory where I want to untar it. I will mention here strip hyphen components,
is equal to 1. So it will untar the file, untar this zip file in this directory which I have just created with the name as Linux kernel. And this process will take some time. It has been successfully unzipped. Now let's go to this location. And here, if I will execute ls command, I will be able to see the source code of Linux kernel. Here, I can use du-sh command to see the total size, that is 1.1 GB. Now in the next step, we will configure the kernel compilation. And there are two methods of configuring the kernel compilation. First method is by copying the config file that came up with this distribution of Linux. And another one is by generating a config file based on the currently connected hardware. Each one has its own advantages and disadvantages. So first I will show you how can we do that by copying the file. So we can mention here cp boot and config. Either you can mention the release, or if you don't know the release, you can mention here the dollar sign, and in the bracket you can mention there uname hyphen r, mention dot, and then you can mention here config. So what it will do, it will copy the config file that came up with the distribution, and it is we can use to gain the support for the wide range of hardware by copying this file. Another method is by generating the config file based on the currently connected hardware, and for that we can execute the make command, make local mode config. Make local mode config. This is the command that we can use. So it will generate a config file based on the currently connected hardware, and it will prompt us. So here we can mention y and press enter like this. So it will prompt us again and again. Here we can keep pressing the enter, and it will generate the config file based on the currently connected hardware, and it can take few minutes in this process. I will go with the first one, and after that I will make or compile the kernel. So we have generated the config file based on the currently connected hardware, but we are not going to use this method. So we will go with the first one. I was just wanting to show you, that is why I executed that command. Now in the next step, we can compile the kernel. And here we will use make deb-pkg command. This command we use if we are using the same file that came up with the distribution. So here we can execute make deb-pkg command. Press enter, and now it will compile the kernel, and this process can take some time, so you will have to wait. I will pause this video for a while and I will keep showing you the process. I will recommend you to use only one CPU core for this process. And here you can see that the compilation is going on. In this method, if you have attached the new hardware, so you will have to compile the kernel again. Means you can use this method if you don't frequently attach the new hardware. And if you attach the new hardware, it will use the default drivers that are there for this kernel. And you can again compile the kernel if you want to include the new drivers for the newly added hardware. And this process, this compilation process will take 20 to 30 minutes in my case, because I am using only one core and my processor is i5. And here I'm using only 2 GB of RAM. So I'm going to pause this video and I will show you the process once it gets completed. 10 minutes are already over and we are still waiting for the completion of this process. About 20 minutes have been already over and we are still waiting for the completion of this process. About 25 minutes have gone and the process is still running. I will keep showing you the process till the end by fast forwarding this and keep pausing the video in certain intervals. And as I was expecting, it will definitely take about 30 to 35 minutes to complete this kernel compilation process in my machine. My machine is running in VMware with only one CPU and we have only 2 GB of RAM. Once this kernel compilation is done, we will get the Debian packages in the parent directory. So we are still waiting for the compilation process to get completed and about 30 minutes are already over and the process is still running. Kernel compilation has been successfully completed and it took around 37 minutes in my case. As the kernel compilation has been completed, now we can get the Debian packages in the parent directory. So we will go back to the parent directory by cd dot dot command and there we can execute sudo dpkg hyphen I linux hyphen asterisk dot deb command and this will install the packages. This will install the Debian packages and the installation for the newly installed kernel will start. Once the installation is done, it will automatically rebuild the init RAM FS on our Ubuntu 20 or in if it does not rebuild the init RAM FS, you can manually do that. So in my case, it has automatically generated the init RAM FS. Now we can reboot the machine. So here we will execute sudo shutdown hyphen R command, shutdown hyphen R now. So it will reboot the machine and once our machine will boot up again, we will verify the kernel release with uname hyphen R command. So we are waiting for the machine to come up and here it is. It is rebooting. It can take few seconds. Now let me again log in the machine. Here I have again logged in the machine and here I'm going to execute the uname hyphen R command and here you can see that the kernel release is 5.9.0, means we have successfully compiled the kernel. Uname hyphen A, we can list the additional details and here we can check etc cat etc os release, it is the file and this is Ubuntu 20.04 on which we have successfully compiled the latest kernel. So guys, that's it for today's session. Hope you will find this video useful. If you like it, then do share it with your friends and colleagues. And if you are new on our channel, please subscribe us and turn on the bell notification to receive the updates of our videos directly in your device. I'll see you in the next session. Till then, bye bye. Jai Hind. Vande Mataram.